स्थले निशायां च नद्याम् अमरमण्डले तुरंगे खंडने वायौ शयने गमनोद्यमे प्रतापे च प्रसादे च चंद्रिकायां कणातपे कवाट पाटने सप्त विभक्त्यर्थे तरंग के विधि प्रवेश भावेपि समत्वे च अंगराग के आत्माते शपते चापि तूषं भावरिदर्शने ताड़पत्रे च केते च द्रव्यादिस्पर्शने तथा आशीर्वाद क्रियायां च नृपश्रेष्ठस्य भावने तत्र तत्रेति वचने सिंधयो सुकृतिक्रमे संबोधने रोगेपि खड्गरूपस्य धारणे मासे संवत्सरे वर्षदिने समाजने तथा एवमत्येषु युज्यन्ते पताकहस्तभावना.
I will begin this story through dance. On a cloudy morning, as the king was walking through a forest, he saw a hunter trap a few pigeons and confronted him, refusing to see the birds kill. The hunter had pointed the arrow to the bird's chest, but then walked away. As night approached, the king decided to take shelter near a river. The whole place was calm and felt like heaven. Even his horse slept next to him. It was as if something had been struck down, but due to the wind, the king slept. After some time, a monk approached him and startled him, causing him to wake up. He praised his prowess in various things and before leaving, blessed him. The king thanked him and looking at the moonlight, he slept again. In the morning, under the scorching heat, the king decided to go where his horse takes him. After some time, they reached a door and the king decided to open it. The door had been inscribed with the 7 keys endings of the Sanskrit grammar, and as the horse walked through a small puddle, it caused ripples on the surface. The king walked through the street and observed various scenarios. Both men and women were working in equanimity. Some people were applying sandal paste on their body, while a few monks were taking an oath in a monastery. The whole place was very silent. The king decided to go into the temple where palm leaf had been used to write scripts. The guards were shielding the entry gate so he couldn't enter, but an elderly monk allowed him in. He touched various sacred objects and before leaving, the monks blessed him and told him he would be an ideal king. The king went out and asked the person for the location near a village, and the person said it was next to the sea. The king reached the village and performed many good deeds. He addressed the head of the village, and the head stepped forward and presented him with a sword. The king, before returning to the kingdom, meditated in the form of Lord Shiva for a month. And even though only a month had passed by, it felt like an year. The king had been blessed with rain. When they heard that the king was returning, they sweeped all the streets to give him a grand welcome. The moral of the story is, when you perform good deeds, God will bless you in one or the other way.